As runoff flows across the surface of the planet, it's going to degrade and erode the landscape. It's going to transport material, and then it's going to deposit that material. Remember, erosion means the incorporation and transportation of material by mobile agents, one of which is running water. Of course, velocity is key to the ability of running water to erode and degrade the landscape. Remember, the faster the water's flowing, the greater its ability to degrade the landscape. Of course, discharge is also important. You can have very fast running water, but it's only a trickle. It's not going to do much on the landscape. But if you increase discharge volume, in other words, you can also increase degradation and erosion. Where are rivers ultimately going to? All streams are attempting to reach what's known as base level. Base level is the lowest level to which a stream can erode. Global base level is sea level, but local base level can be the level of a lake, which also means this, that as water's flowing across the surface of the planet, ultimately it is trying to reach the ocean. And at that point, that flowing water stops moving, kind of. If you look at this diagram here, you can see that running right through the middle of it, there's this stream that comes from the higher part of the landscape, goes over a waterfall, goes across on the flat part, another waterfall, reaches a lake, continues to flow, and then ultimately reaches the ocean. That red arrow is pointing at base level. At that point, that stream system stops moving. You don't see the stream going down into the ocean, do you? No. Now, I will tell you this to be completely honest about it. When the Mississippi River reaches the Gulf of Mexico, it of course doesn't just immediately stop, but the currents don't go all the way to Cuba either. They flow offshore for a couple of tens of miles, and then that's it. Even the Amazon, the biggest river in the world, its currents only go out a couple of hundred miles. They don't go all the way to Africa, because they are going to slow down and stop as a result of friction with the water. If you see where the yellow arrow is pointing, that yellow arrow is pointing at a lake. That lake acts as a temporary base level for that river system. So all the time, rivers are trying to reach base level. And in fact, if the tectonic process is stopped and the rest of the planet somehow magically was able to stay as is, which would not happen, but if it was, and we continue to have red running water going across the surface of the planet, ultimately what would happen is the rivers would cut everything down to base level. All nuances on the landscape would be gone. That means the mountains, the hills, everything would be completely wiped out and we would be flattened out at base level. Take a look at this diagram also. You can see that on the upper course, what's happening is the river is relatively thin, and then it widens as it comes down through the middle course, and then the lower course, supposed to be lower course, of course. You know, when you steal something, you don't get to have everything all the time. So I apologize to whoever I took this from. And then what happens is it reaches the ocean. When it reaches the ocean, where the red arrow is pointing, that is base level, and the river stops moving at that point.